If this is your first time to the channel, consider subscribing, press the bell icon, and never miss an update. Hello friends, like I always say, this video is going to be a special one. As we own different RX series bikes, RX100, RX135G, or maybe RXZ, there are a couple of things that we need to take care of. Otherwise, the bike will have small niggles and those niggles turn into bigger problems. So this video will help you to make sure that your bike stays in ship shape. So kindly stay till the end. So I cannot emphasize enough on the usage of the right tools, because you know, most of the bikes that we see these days have damaged screws, they have damaged nuts, they have damaged bolts. It's all because of using wrong tools, and that kind of becomes very difficult to, you know, fix once you are taking apart these bikes. And it also leads to a lot of frustration because you are not able to remove a particular part. So always get the right kind of tools, learn from other people's experience. Initially I also used to be somebody who would use a plier where T-spanner is required, but always remember these tools are made for a reason and use them to make sure there is no damage. So these are a couple of tools which every DIY guy should own, and it should be in your toolbox so that it can help you to perform these repairs at your home. So a couple of tools that you guys can collect is, first you need a plug spanner, which is very important. Then you need certain ring spanner combinations like 10, 12 and 13. Then need T-spanners on the same size, which is 10, 12 and 13. Then also try to get an impact screwdriver, so that should cover all, you know, four bits that you might require to take apart the bike. Then get a nylon mallet. So these are things that you would need no matter what. So there is nothing better than preventive maintenance, and preventive maintenance can prevent a lot of issues like the name suggests. So make sure you wash your bike every week. Make sure it is completely dry. It is kept away from water splashes. So keep it in a clean state. If there is dirt and grime, it will cause issues. So we'll first start with how to adjust the clutch. So what you need to do is, you need a 10 size spanner or a T-spanner, loosen this nut and use a flathead screwdriver to make the screw inside barely tight, and then turn it about a quarter turn out so that the clutch is now set properly. Now we are talking about the front brake. So you adjust the brake adjuster in such a way that there is about 5 to 8 mm of play in the lever. This is done in order to make sure that the bike doesn't ride on the brakes. You can also do the adjustment in the wheel. This, you know, play adjustment can be done in two places. However, if you want to adjust the rear brake, the play adjustment can only be done near the rear wheel. There is a nut which you can loosen in the brake rod to adjust the play. The play for the rear brake lever is about 20 to 30 mm. So make sure that kind of play is there. Otherwise, there is a good chance that you might be riding the brakes. So one thing that most of us don't know or either don't pay attention to is the amount of air to be added in the tire. Before that, another thing which is important is, you need to know how old is your tire. If it is more than 3 to 4 years, it is better to replace it. Air pressure in the tire should be around 22 psi in the front if it's only the rider, and 28 in the rear. If you have a passenger also, it should be around 32 psi. To be safe, on the rear you can put 30 psi, because you would not know when you will have a pillion, but it is always better to not cross 30. Okay, now next is the chain slack. So there is a small inspection window in the chain cover. Remove that and then see how much distance the chain moves vertically. So this distance should be within 20 to 30 mm. If it is more than that, it should be adjusted properly. If it is less than that, then chances of the chain breaking or slipping is very high. So make sure that is taken into consideration when you tighten the chain. So to tighten the chain, what you need to do is, when you look at the swing arm, there are two nuts, one on the side where the sprocket sits and one on the other side. The one on the other side is around 22 mm, the one on the sprocket is around 24 or so, I don't remember it exactly. So just loosen those and then make sure after that you start adjusting the chain adjuster. So there are two things that you need to be sure about. So there is a 12 mm nut on the chain adjuster and a 10 mm nut. So you need to loosen that 12 mm nut and adjust the 10 mm nut on both the side equally. Okay. Next we are going to talk about the steering. So this is the nut you need to tight. If the handle is a little loose, how do you check if the handle or the fork is loose? You put it in the center stand, grab by both your hands and then start rocking it. If it is moving, that means the handle needs to be tightened. So I'm not going to talk about batteries because batteries are now maintenance proof, and even if there is an issue with the battery, it is better to take it to a battery shop and get it checked. Okay. So moving on, next is something that you have to be careful about without saying, do not touch hot engine, make sure the battery acid doesn't leak on you, etc., etc. So now we talk about each item that you need to check. Okay. We are not going to talk about the break-in or the thereafter period because most of the bikes are now at least 20 to 30 years old. So the break-in period doesn't apply to it as of now. But if you are, let's say, rebuilding the engine, then you have to go through the break-in period. The spark plug needs replacement in the first 1,000 kilometers if you're breaking in. If not, every 5,000 to 6,000 kilometers you do that, though it says 3,000, but I feel it is too soon. But you can clean the spark plug in between, check it. Air filter element needs to be replaced every 5,000. Before that, in around 3,000, you check and clean it and also re-oil it. Carburetor needs to be adjusted for idling as well as for the air screw every 3,000 to 6,000 kilometers. You need to check fuel lines for crack. You need to check the oil level, the engine oil or the transmission oil level, at around 3,000 kilometers and replace it every 6,000 to 5,000 kilometers. Brake needs adjustment, both front and rear. Clutch, you need to check the operation, make sure that the play is taken care of. Then check the rear swing arm. If there is play, you need to replace the bush every 5,000 to 6,000 kilometers. If not, adjust it. Wheel, you need to check the bearings, make sure it is not making any noise or it is not shaking sideways. The spark plug should be BP7HS only. Make sure that it is this or equivalent. The gap of the spark plug should be 0.7 to 0.8 mm. It's better to buy a feeler gauge and check the gap, because most of the spark plugs that come from the factory do not have the right gap. And then there is decarbonization. For the decarbonization, take the flute or the exhaust baffle out, clean it with a wire brush, take the head off, clean it with a wire brush, and also clean the top of the piston with a wire brush. So that's how you do the decarbonization. So now we have spoken about checking the air element or the air filter element, and also how to oil that. So what you need to do is you need to dip it in 2T oil and squeeze it with one hand. Don't apply too much of pressure and never ever wring it. Just squeeze it to squeeze the extra oil off and then just install it back. Every 6,000 kilometers, it is better to change the air filter element. And please, for the love of God, don't get those 30-year-old air filter element, because they are not going to filter anything. So it is always better to replace the transmission oil when the engine is warm. Make sure that you apply the right torque, that is 14 foot pounds, and not what the, you know, grease monkey mechanic does, wherein you apply all the force and then, you know, crack the crankcase. Also, you know, I have covered the auto lube pump setting and calibration in details in a video, so please watch that. The carburetor can be adjusted in two places. One is, you know, on the top of the carburetor and one near the accelerator. And there are two separate adjustments because there is an adjustment for the oil pump as well. So make sure you adjust it in such a way that the play is maintained, which is around 5 to 8 mm, which means 5 to 8 mm of your accelerator should be free. If it is not, then chances of, you know, it getting stuck is pretty high. Then, like I said, I have always mentioned pilot air screw should always be 1.5 turns out from full tight. The engine RPM should be approximately 1150 to 1200. So these are things that you need to pay attention to. Make sure that these are as per spec. So that would take care of your bike for a much longer time. It will ensure that you have a you know, pretty smooth running engine, pretty smooth running bike. Make sure that you inspect your cables as well every 3000 kilometers, which is not mentioned here, because these cables need lubrication. So make sure you lubricate them. And if you feel that the cables are getting stuck, go ahead and replace those. Don't wait for you know, for it to fail, because these cables ideally don't break. They first go little hard and then is when it breaks. So make sure that you lubricate the cables before they break. Okay, so like I said, all these things as per the checklist you can see on your screen needs to be done. So make sure everything is as per the checklist. If you do that, then your bike will be problem free. They won't have any niggles. If you see below, you can see that it is saying to check the ignition timing. So for an RX100 and above, which has a CDI ignition, you do not have to worry about the ignition timing, because the timing is set from the factory and it doesn't, you know, change as and when it runs. Make sure you take care of all the bearings, like all the wheel bearings should not be noisy. There should not be any wobble in the wheels. So every 3,000 to 5,000 kilometers, you check if the wheels are wobbly. If it is, then make sure you check if it is due to, you know, the spokes losing tension. If that is the case, get it fixed. Otherwise, you will end up losing the bearing on the wheel. So a bike which is maintained as per the specification won't need an engine rebuild within 1 lakh kilometers. And trust me, I'm not exaggerating it, because my own RX100 has run about 1 lakh kilometers without needing an engine rebuild. So that is something which is achievable. And if you follow the company maintenance cycles, it would, you know, work, and it would go a long way. So I hope this should help you to understand, you know, how to do maintenance yourself. So if it does, give the video a thumbs up, and, you know, kindly share it with your friends who also might to, you know, who also want to do some DIY on their bikes and make sure they run in ship shape. So thanks a lot for watching. Have a wonderful day. Bye bye.